but I just want to make sure I don't leave this out at all. I had written up some few notes about the green group, but really, when I got reading it, I thought, you know, it applies to any group. And things that you want to think about when you get on your horse. First of all, you want to evaluate your horse mentally and physically and think about what its past experience was. Is this something that we have to undo before we start to train? Or are we starting from scratch? We want to have a goal for the day. We want it to be realistic. We want to have expectations that we hope are going to happen that day. We want to remember that each horse is an individual. It's not one size that fits all. You have to adjust your lesson to accommodate your horse's comfort zone. You want to listen to your horse. Make sure what they're telling you is not a one-way conversation. You're always pushing the envelope a little bit, asking him to do things, but you want to be ready to lessen your demands if the horse starts losing confidence or getting mentally rattled. If you lose their mind, the lesson of the day is gone, and you really can scar their future learning. But you don't want to push them too far. You want to be very sensitive to the reactions of your horse showing you whatever you're asking him to do. Take that into consideration whether you're asking too much or not. You may have to go back and skip back a step and let him do something that he knows and that he's comfortable with to keep up his confidence. Try to end each session on a good note. And before starting any jumping lessons, be sure your horse is fresh, that your horse is doing pretty well on the flat. If he's not doing pretty well on the flat, you want to really limit your jumping. And unless you have those controls on the flat, it's not going to work out too well. You want to try to keep each session about half an hour to 45 minutes. Just like kids come to the classroom and sit them down. When they first come in there, they want to sit there and kind of get organized. It takes about 5 minutes of getting settled. Then you've got a good 20 minutes of teaching them something. Then they start to get a little mentally or physically fatigued, and so do the horses. So you get some good training time for about 20 minutes, maybe 45. You want to recognize if your horse is getting tired mentally or physically, not just physically. And you want to repeat when you're asking them to do something, repeat it two or three times. If they do it two or three times, don't keep doing it, because then if they've answered your request, they'll think they did something wrong and they're just bored with it. Make your rides count. Don't just ride around arbitrarily and exercise them. Make sure you're developing a little bit of program with them at the same time. You want to make sure that you never develop a strong fit horse before you have them develop the basics on the flat. When the body gets stronger than the mind, they can use that strength against you. And then they're going to be resisting some of your aids. You want to develop their mind and their body together. Have a goal for each day, but be ready to adjust it. And when the horse will tell you when it's ready for the next step. Listen to the horse and be ready to be patient. And that's with the green horses, really, or any horse. You want to keep those things in mind. And I can't tell you how many times I've come out thinking I'm going to jump this course with a horse, and all of a sudden it's shying, it's spooking, it's snorting, breathing fire, and I think, well, maybe not. There's strategies of it. They will adjust your program. I've got this great little book here by Hans Sen, Apropos Horses and Riders. It's just a little black book. Somebody left it in my house. I don't know who left it, but it's a great find. And I've picked up a few books and I've tried to read them about riding or horses or whatever. And I put them to sleep. I read about a chapter. I find about maybe four sentences that I really wanted to underline. But this little book is just, everything is very concise and it's very simple. And it gets right to the point. I started to try and highlight it, and then I thought, I'm highlighting every line, because this guy has already boiled it down, and he has great little sayings. It's about horses and riding, and I talked to the guy before he passed away. He passed away not terribly long ago. I called him up about this book. I ordered about 20 of them. I ordered about 20 of them twice now, because it's a fabulous book. I only give them to my friends and loan them out, because they were self-published and you can't, not making anymore. But it's a great little book, and it's about riding, but really it's about life. You know, the way he explains things, he has a wonderful way of condensing things and putting it in a little way that's easier to understand. I'm always not going to read you a whole bunch of stuff here, but a couple of the little things that he says. Let's see. some of the outside rain. The outside rain is so important when you're turning that you make sure that you always block with your outside leg and your outside rein, so that when you go to turn them, they can't just bulge and continue around the corner. He says the outside rein should feel like a rubber band, and that's a good way to put it. So it's not a stiff, locked thing. It has some give to it. And always remember that the horse will follow his shoulders, not his head. We think he's going to follow his head. He pulls his head around, but the body keeps going that way. Just as in conversation, you need to know when to talk and when to listen. He went on to all these little things about the horse and relaxation. And so I called him up and I said what a great book I thought it was. I said, you know, it's so nice. He obviously really understood horses. And he had an accent. He said, yes, he said, I tried to write the book from the horse's viewpoint. And I said, and he did. I said, I thought it once in a while, but maybe writing a book, and he wrote it. That's perfect. If you ever get a chance to get this book, to look at it, Apropos Horses and Riders by Hans Sandler, that's it. Now, you probably might be able to get it if you went on the internet or something. It's just real worthwhile looking at. So that's enough of that story here. We're going to pick up where we left off yesterday a little bit. That's what I was saying when you warm up doing your trot, walk, trot, see how that's going. And now we're just one time each, we're going to get one shot each going down, thinking of a left leg canter and at the wall, a simple change, at this lattice work, a simple change, stop on a straight line, back 6 steps. See how we do today. Now one thing, what did we learn yesterday from that exercise? Pardon?
Start early.
Don't assume. Never know anything like never assume. Don't assume that horse is going to pull right up when you pull those reins. Start well in advance. Start to respond well. So, okay, I'll soften my hand and let him continue a little further so I can hit my mark. But I want the change of lead to happen at the wall, not after the wall. At the lattice work with the LFOs, not after that. So you've got to get the horse back before those points so that you can walk a couple steps so you are cantering at those points. Man, you get to go first again. Lucky you. You want to lean back a little bit to settle down in the tack so you feel it more through your hips. There, that's good. Good. And again, you want to make sure you're straight. You can see how after the second lead change, the tracks in the sand are starting to drift left. Pick yourself a straight point to ride down to, ride all the way down to it. Now, even though you had difficulty, that's pretty good. Good. Even though you had difficulty with getting that first change of lead cleanly, you were quick enough to catch it before it was the wrong one that you wanted. And that's what we're after. Even if it takes you a little more time, make sure you get the job done. Don't just burst forward and canter and think you did a great job if you're on the wrong lead. You see your tracks in the sand there, how they've drifted off again to the left. Great. Discipline yourselves to ride your horses straight. Okay. And what are you going to think about today? We needed to work on. What hand where? What hand is always pulling on your horse's head? Yes. And what does your right one do sometimes that I don't like? Because the right one every now and then, when you go to canter, you go, whoop! Oh no. One hand on one side? Okay, relax. One hand on one side and the other. What else are we going to do today? Good. All right. Let's do it. I'm going to go over there, pick up your canter, and do two simple changes. Can we do that? Alright. Go back, don't pull. Here with your leg, right leg. Only right leg. Get that left leg off. There you go. Remember, the pony's going to move away from your pressure of your leg. So if you want it to go over to the railing, you've got to push it with the left leg. That's it. And then sit and canter. Good. Right rein. One hand on one side of the neck, one hand on the other. Plant ahead. Slow down. That's slow. Lean back. And one hand on one side, one on the other. done. And try the backing up a little bit. See if you can back up a little bit. Take a little bit. Give take, take. Right rein. Right rein. Pull the pony back straight. Take your time. Patient. Take back with your rein. Good. Take again. Take again. Left leg rein. Take with your left rein. Take. Take. Take a little more. That's right. Good. Okay. Soften your hand. Catch your pony. And come on back. That was very good. That was much, much better. And that was a hard lead to pick up there, that first change. And your hand stayed down. There is a big improvement from yesterday. Okay, Jamie. Now look at me for a minute. Don't see how round you can get your shoulders in the back. You let your arms reach without rounding your shoulders. You can reach from this way, but no rounding your shoulders for this, okay? All right. Soft hand. Three horses to the glider, and then you glide. Everything is smooth and quiet and slow. Now what about your lead? Check your lead. How's your lead? Let's make a circle around, start again. Just slow trot, big wide turn. As you get to the railing, just lay that right leg back. Let your horse come forward. To your left rein. Right leg is right after. Right leg, that way. So this is done for your leg, not your hand. Good. Hands low, relax your arm, relax your shoulder. Take back now. Take back and walk. Just walk with your left leg on. And then canter. Big field, you want to canter. Stop. Keep that left leg on so the horse moves to the right as it goes forward. Forward to the right. To the right. That's right. Okay, good. Good. So you just always have to make them straight. Try a little back. And left them good. Okay, good. And then walk forward and give them a little tap. That's pretty good. So you just have to wait a minute to make sure you feel your horse moving away from the asking leg. Before you actually asked for the canter to part. As soon as you took your time there, you picked it right up. So make sure, so like when you want to pick up the outside lead, which leg is going to be your strongest one? If you're going to pick up the right lead, going this direction. Yeah. And so you want to make sure he understands that. So make sure you feel him start to try and actually go to the right. Then says, now, pardon? That's right. But you have to go forward. That's the trick. You have to go forward and sideways. If you go sideways first, you're still going to lose it. Forward and then sideways. And which way you're turning this way, left, where you're walking, walk forward and back. Just lay your right leg back and squeeze them a little with your right leg and slow them down slightly. Push your only your right leg. Get your left leg off him. Only right leg. There. See how he's playing over there? And you move away from pressure. You really need very little hand. If you steer with your leg, go straight to me and turn right. You're going to lean back, lay your left leg back, and just push him with your left leg. Lean back, look right. And just your left, no right leg, only left leg, a little bit of every stride. Now. Good. Now, there you go. We want him to go forward and around. Always think forward and around. So he's ready to come back. This is nice. Too much. Okay? All right. Who's next here? All right. Good. nice changes, nice and straight, very rhythmic, very supple. The mayor hardly ever changed top line when she took back. She came back in a nice spongy fashion, staying perfectly straight. She obviously doesn't know too much about the backing, but Elizabeth was stood there. She just patiently waited for a minute until she could kind of get the idea. And once she started getting a little backward motion, she began to pick up on what she wanted. And you can't, with the backing, if they don't understand it, you can't force it real hard, because what will they do if you force it real hard? They'll rear up, because they feel boxed in. You know, you're pulling and pulling and they're standing still, they don't get it. And then they try to just bust loose out of it. Bust loose. Off. And you're trying to get them to listen, and you feel them getting a little tense so that you can still keep your leg there to get the change. Talk to them a little so they relax into it. Okay, good. Very good. Very nice. And that, you know, that was a good exercise. You did it nicely because you showed feel. And I'm saying, again, I'm sure if I repeated it, I don't know which group I repeated it to, but as I say, my father used to tell me that he could teach me what to do, but he couldn't teach me when. And that was a good example of, she had to wait it out a minute, wait it out a minute. You have to be patient. There are times you cannot force it. You'll clock, stay there, wait for it to respond. Okay, let's come on back here again. Is that horse really green? Oh, that's Renaissance, he's past green.
He's purple.
He's purple. Oh, Renaissance together. What did you learn about Renaissance? You need to not hold them straight, push them straight. Push them straight. Otherwise, it's bulges and carriage. Let's try that one more time. Even now, walking. Lean back. Left rein against his neck. He starts to drift to the left. Don't just pull in the right rein. Lean back. Use your left leg and get his head straight. Push forward first. Push him over and then straighten. Push him over to straighten. Left leg and left rein against his neck keeps him over there. And he came back very quickly when you asked him to come back for the first change so that you could have let him canter another step or two forward so you wouldn't have quite so much walking to do. Canter, keep that canter. Now back. Stay behind him now. Walk. Pluck him. Good. Take him back now. Don't wait. Don't wait. Straight, straight, straight. So we're going to give you one more shot at it. So you've got to keep him straight. And that's a bit, so far, that's our biggest problem with Renaissance, is that he's never straight. When he's straight, he does things just fine. So you're going to have to push him straight and learn about the indirect rein. If he's trying to fall to the left, don't just pull on the right rein. Lean back. Add left leg and left, ride him up to the left rein, then open the right. So you've got to block him. You can't let his shoulder bulge. Hands lower, very low, very low. Ride him to two reins to slow down, to stop, keeping your left leg on him as you slow down. Left leg now, as you walk. That's right. Think about slowing down smoothly. And now your right leg on him as you slow down. But don't let him turn. Open that. There you go. Good. There you go. Much better. All right. Good. So you have to push your horse straight, not pull it straight. Especially if one's not really going forward, then you really can't pull it straight. Remember again, they don't follow their head, they follow their shoulders, so block that shoulder. Okay, I got it. Relax, lean back, relax a little more into the rhythm of your canter. There, that's better. Stay in the rhythm of your canter. Stay back. Relax. Stay back. All right, let's come on back. Come back, try it again. Now, you can't, when you're trying to get the hindquarters over to the right, you've got the right idea, but you're using too much left brain, so that it's overcompensating for what we want to do. We do want to get, too much one rein. You do want to get his haunches over, too much left brain. You want to get his haunches over, but you're going to have to push his haunches over so it goes forward into the side before you can. Soften your hand as you go into the canter so he doesn't have to pull you into the canter. Follow him. That's right. Good. Follow him into the canter. Let go a little bit, don't grab him too tight. And as you stop him, start putting your left leg on him, gently. Lean back, let go, lean back. Go, slow down, make him go to the right, more right rein, left leg to right rein. No, he's behind you, stop. I'm gonna give you one more shot and then we're finished with your turn. He has to go forward to the rein to get the angle you want. You can't pull him back to the angle. Relax into the canter. Don't freeze up in your shoulders. Relax through your shoulders and armpit. And then as you slow down, start putting your left leg on him. Just gently, gently, gently. Walk with your left leg on him. Hands down, hands down, hands down. Here. Now left leg, pushing you forward to your right rein. To your right rein. Like you're going to go right. Yes. Hand down. Relax, relax. Push him forward first, forward, and then canter. So fluff. Good. Okay. So you see again, when you get a little anxious to get that job done, and you start forcing it, the horse freezes up, and then it won't go any direction. You have to wait till you feel that little relaxed movement going forward, and then ask for your canter. Find gently both reins and then a little left, a little right, a little left, a little right, a little left. And then both reins, a little left rein. Good. That's right. Oops, a little left rein, left leg. Okay, that's enough. So you see, well, a lot of us, we all need to practice on this backing. It's all very stilty and crooked. So you've got to get, and you will be able to catch that horse the minute it starts to cock itself one way or the other. You add a little bit outside rein, outside leg. And be careful that they don't get going the other way then. So be able to be quick to catch it. Okay, we're all done with that? Okay. So we're going to go on to the jumping. And we're going to do our little trot dance once each. And let's jump the jump at once, turn around and jump it once more, and then we'll back down. And then don't let the horses... We haven't jumped today. Don't let them phase out on you and stop. Not that we have to rush them, but you might even have to stay behind them a little bit, crossing the first rail, and add a cluck and hands low to keep the horse going forward. 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 Ah! Come around again. So that horse is already slowing down. You can't wait to see what's going to happen. You're going to have to override it if they're hanging back. Take your time on the way to the rail. When you get to the rail, you make sure they go someplace. Hand low. Sit down and push. Yeah, that's it. Look where you want to go. Look. Hand low. Okay. That's right. Terrain. Steady balance to his back. Get it into a nice rhythm of his back. Slow, but don't assume he's just going to jump it as you cross that rail. You sit into him and make sure he keeps going. Good. Lean back. Lean back, sit down. Let him come forward and then to you. That's pretty good. So look back to where you want to ride forward to. And now trot. Take your time. Bend your elbows. Without leaning too far back. Good. So sometimes when you want to get them back, if you lean too far back to do that last little pull, you actually drive yourself into their back harder and it makes them go stronger. So it's good to sit up, but you don't want to lean over the back of their tail. Stay alert. Be ready with your truck. Your hands very low. Sit, 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 sit. Now, aggressive. Come on. That's aggressive. Ah. Pick him up a little bit. Okay, walk around again. And you won't be able to throw the rein away when you have one you can't quite trust. Keep a little feel. Which means you have to push enough that your leg overpowers your hand. Lean back. Sit. 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 Push. Where's your leg? Where's your leg? That's right. Your leg has to be there. Lean back. Lean back. Lean back. Let the horse come forward. Lean back. Let him carry you. Lean back. Lean back. Now trot. Lean back. Lean back. Don't keep pulling yourself up out of the tack. Stay down in the tack. Now again, as you cross that rail and you sit, you put your legs on that horse, and you might need a cluck, you might not, but you put your legs on it. That's a cluck. Good. Lean back. Let that horse carry you around the turn, and back. And then you can balance it. Let it come forward, then balance for the turn. Put your lead again. Lean back. Open your right hand and walk a minute. So if we have trouble with horses popping your leads off, how are you going to keep it on the same lead? If you're on the right lead and you want to stay on the right lead, but you know you're going to have to steady the horse, how do you make sure that it stays on the right lead? Pardon? You first, yeah, you want to do it in the right order. Walk first and open the right side. Open the right side. Whichever lead you want, you keep that rein against the neck. Don't keep that rein against the neck. You want to use it as a direct, not an indirect. Indirect rein makes them pop over to the other lead. Okay. But when we cross that rail, you'll just keep your leg on. Don't just ride off your eye in the rhythm. You want to be solid for your horse. Okay. Spread those shoulders. You can reach forward with your arm, but you don't get to round the shoulders to do it. You can reach, but you can't cave in at the stomach. Slow and low hands, very low hands, so they're steady. Terrain. Sit. A little push. Nice. Nice. Look right. Hand low. Feel every stride through your hips. Nice. Two steady low hands. Look to your right. Has a little seat. The leg up. The two reins low. Good. Trot. Trot. Bend your elbows. Slow trot. Wide turn. Slow and wide. Hands down. Hands down. As you take your time. Two hands. Guide to the center. And then add a little leg. Good. Think right. Right. Look where you want to go. Canter. Keep your canter. Cluck. Cluck. Off your hand so it doesn't break. It goes forward to slow down. Forward, 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 forward. So he doesn't drop out behind you. Okay, good. Good. That's it. That's it. Very good. All right. Thank you. really good. And that was really, that's what I'm looking for, that same rhythm from the beginning to end. The horse didn't look like it was fighting or worried. She wasn't worrying or getting overzealous, pushing or pulling. It looked like it was just smooth and happening. Good. You want to lean a little bit further back, Heidi. Let your lower leg come further forward. You don't want to get up ahead of your horse. Hand low, sit. Make sure the pony continues forward from your leg. Nice, very good. Very good. Now sit down, lean back, and let the pony come forward, then balance it as you turn. Good. Lean way back. Let the pony carry you. There, that's right. Let it come forward. Good. Softly back. Nice. That's right. Easy trot. Lower leg just at the girth, not too far back with that lower leg. And sit. Just push the pony forward a little with your leg. Good. Lean back. Let the pony come forward to balance on your hand to turn. That's good. Good. Okay, that's good. And back along, very nice. Okay, sometimes, I don't know, did we do something with your stirrups yesterday or not? Did we lengthen them yesterday? Somebody, pardon? You did. Yeah, so you need them at least that long. You don't want to let your leg get too far back, because then you don't stay in the middle of the time. Get your upper body to come forward. That's good. Hands low and steady. Don't let them bounce around because loves to interpret that as slow down. Sit. Push. Push. Whoop. Come on around again. So you've got to make sure that they are taking you a little bit, especially the first 10 of the day. You can't afford just to jump up their neck. The rails will hold them, so it's not like you push hard, they're not going to bypass it. Sit, sit down, sit, push, push, ah, but you pulled at the same time. Come around, do that fence the same direction. You push and let it hit your hand as a dead end, so it stopped him just as he's going to leave the ground. You've got to keep pushing across that rail. Wide turn, don't cut your corner, because then you have your horse at a dead, no rhythm to start with. Let's turn around here, turn around this way, turn around to the left, do the wide turn, two reins, not one rein to turn. Steer with your legs and both reins, then both reins gently. Now as you cross that rail, those hands need to stay down. They can't pick at his face as he drops them off the ground, or he's not going to come off the ground. Hand low, put him on the neck, and push it. There. Push again, and then push, 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 whatever you can. So you've got to tell him, you've got to participate here. You're just going for the ride, and he doesn't know what you want to do. Walk, trot, canter, jump. Let him know what you want to do. Push him, push him, push him, push him. Then you're only going to wait. Trot, trot, wide turn. Keep some rhythm going. The two of you are slumbering through this here. Live trot. Keep a feel of your right rein. You keep on throwing the right rein away and hanging on the left. Two reins. Balance with two reins. Sink and leg to a soft two reins low. Push to the rein. Push! Push! Is that as hard as you can push? Is that as hard as you can push? Okay. Can't you keep him cantering? You've got to try it one more time. You've got to keep him cantering. You land over it and you just sort of like a dish rag. He goes, good idea. He does the same thing. You're supposed to keep cantering when you land. You've got to help him participate here a little bit. Both legs, both reins. Sort of reins are not tight. Soft, low hands. Sit your trot. Clamp those legs in like it's life and death. Clamp those legs in, it's life and death. Look left. So, and you've got to recognize what lead you're on when you land, okay? I'm going to help you because it takes a little practice doing this. When you land, I'm going to tell you which lead you're on, so you'll know which way to turn, okay? Legs, come, legs, the boat reins. You can't be wishy-washy with those legs. If they're going to bobble around, he's not going to go. He doesn't know what you want. Sit. Clamp your ankles. Hands down. Clamp your ankles. Clamp them. Clamp your ankles. Left, left, left. Look. Turn. Push. 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 Roll back and reverse. No. Did you watch anybody else do this? Did you?
What?
Did you watch everybody else do this?
Yeah.
Did you watch where they went?
Yeah.
They didn't go around that jump. They didn't go crisscross over there and do a flying change. This is trot. He jumped the fence, land cantering, keep cantering. You land left, turn left, and do a rollback at the canter. Come back, trot. Jump the jump, land cantering. Whatever lead you land on, go straight to the railing, turn that way. Try it once more, turn one more time now. But you've got to get it in your mind. Let's get animated here. Trot. Get a trot. Just a trot. Sit. Hands down. Hands down. Push. Don't fall back on the rein. Push. Left. Push. Turn. Straight across. Over to the blue tent. Blue tent. No, that's not the exercise we're doing. No, you don't. Go back on. Let's go to the other side. Watch somebody else go. So when you're standing over there, don't be taking a little nap. Watch the others so you know what the program is. Short ring, but not tight. Hands very low, Austin. You've got to stay awake for the first fence. You know the pony's not going to do it unless you make it do it. So you're going to sit, put your hands down, and grind your heel like you mean it. Grind it. Attaboy. Good. Turn left. Look where you want to turn. Straight to the blue tent. Right to the blue tent, and then a roll back. Tuck, keep going, attaboy. Look back at me. You're going to reverse and back to the trot now. Two reins, slow, gentle, 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 slower, slower, much slower, much slower, Austin. Patient and very low, sit. And you're going to mean it when you get that cross that rail. Mean it. Yes, attaboy. Left turn, canter, lean back, push. Push, steer with those legs, not your hands, steer with your legs. Attaboy, good. Look over your left shoulder, lean back, right leg, pushes that pony around, and trot, and walk. That was a big improvement today, big improvement. Hands stay much steadier, you look where you're going. Very good, good job. Okay, is that it? What did they give you when we're here? You were here yesterday, but I'm morning here, isn't it? Okay, give me another chance. Did you see the program that we were going? Because the trot and jump, land cantering, go straight toward the cone, whichever cone you're going towards, and then as soon as you, and whatever lead you're on, you're going to turn that way, and you do a rollback, a pretty tight rollback, trot, and go again. Did you get it?
When you say rollback, come left, go towards the blue tent, and
yes.
Make a circle and come to this side.
And then come back toward me. Trot. Now, if you happen to land, that's if you're going that way and you land right, you do that, you come that way, I'm sorry. If you're going this way and you land left, yes. Go toward the blue tent, make a roll back this way. If you landed right, you'd have to turn right, go by the gentleman sitting there, pass the cone, turn right, and you roll back toward the gate there. Whichever lead you're on, and I'm going to tell you which lead you're on. And that, again, that's something, if you haven't done the exercise, you know, it makes the decision after come up pretty early. And I want you to make sure you go the right direction. But you've got to be definite about you want to do it. You don't let your hands pop up in the air in front of the jump. But that takes it away. As they cross that rail, you've got to be thinking forward with your hand low. And encourage them to sit and use your legs. Hard, ankle, tight, look. Nice. Right turn. Lean back, lean, turn, push, push, push. Faster, 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 faster. All the way up to the cone, all the way up there. Faster, faster. And there, do a roll back and reverse. Look back at the gate. Don't pull, push. Left leg, left leg, left leg. Now trot, slowly trot. Trot, stay on the rail. Left leg, slower, slower, so he doesn't come off the rail. Look back at your jump. Good, hands low. Sit, Help him with your leg and jump. Hand down. That's it. Right turn. Push. Push. Don't pull. Push. Push him to the left leg. Push him. Push both legs. Straight, 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 straight. And then turn. Now turn right. Hanner. 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 Back to me. Back to me. And then that way. Cross. 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 Okay, that's the right one. But you really have to push your core. She's not going anywhere. There's nothing bad. She's waiting for the sun. I mean, you just sit there. She just sits there. She's not helping. Okay, well done. Now we're going to get out of the way a little bit so that we can kind of jump just this fence off the left lead. So you need to line up down there. Then people are watching and see between those two jumps up there, the brown one and the white one. And we're just going to pick up a left knee canter, circle half the ring, jump this brown jump, and stop on the straight line. You can either go all the way up like Anna did, or you can use half the ring either way. Lean back a little bit more, let the horse come in front of you. With your seat closed. Good. So you can see a little slide, turn to the right. Because most horses learn through repetition and they're used to seeing the end of the ring and wanting to turn, they're all probably going to show you a little drift to the left. So what we're going to do is stop, canter forward and stop on a straight line, then walk forward and turn to the other side. So instead of turning left after that jump, at the end, we're going to turn right. Okay. Oh, there you go. Not your hand, leg. The pony, you have to steer your pony with your leg. Very little hand. Right leg makes it turn left. Short rein, but not tight. Sit when you want to canter and push. Push. Remember that left hand, it can't be a claw. It has to be soft, that left hand soft. Low with it, low with it, low with it, left hand. Leg now, be definite with it, pony. Leg, don't you be nice to it. Leg, leg, leg. Oh boy, straight, straight, straight rein, right rein, right rein, right rein. Okay, okay, not bad, not bad. You make sure that you soft in that left rein, not bad. All right. Better. That was better. So the more you all can get used to the concept of steering with your seat and legs, not so much your hand, the better off. Circle, 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 and stop canning. Stop. So the main thing we want to do is we want to make sure you take your time getting your canter. First things first. Get it organized, get your canter, get your rhythm, then aim for the jump. Till you've gotten the canter smoothly on the correct lead, don't even think about the jump. One thing at a time. Great. Good. Good. And we're going to steer with your seat close, your legs close to the sides, and hands low and steady in. Right to the center with your leg on. Nice. Smoothly straight back. Right rein, right rein, right rein. Good. And turn right. Forward, forward to turn right. You'll always go forward and then turn, not turn, and then go forward. Forward, then turn. Okay, Heidi? The lower leg will stay close to the girth. It won't get too far back. That'll keep you from getting too far ahead with your shoulders. Hands down and push. You need to push. That's why you had a dead jump. You can't ride your horses backward. You have to push them to your hand. You can't pull them to your legs. Okay? Go back to line. We're going to try that again. Everybody will go one more time. Okay, who do we have next? Marissa? Here? No, no, no. Why do I say no, no, no? What's going wrong? He's already falling to the side. He goes forward straight. You don't let him cut the corner. Then you canter. Yeah. You can't leave it to multiple choice or optional for these horses. You have to let them know what you want. Solid. Solid. No. No. And I'd make a wider turn than that so he doesn't learn to cut the corner anyway. You've got to get him alive. He's barely moving. He's, I don't think he's breathing. Come on, push. Push. Don't steer with your hand. Push. Push. I want you to think you're late for dinner. You need to think of dinner. Now we're talking. Now we're talking. Oh, hold up, 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 up. Take him right back there. Take him right back there. Hold him straight. Wait, wait, TA. No, turn him around. Stop it. Show him that jump. Show him that jump. Kick him up. Oh, oh, oh. Now turn around and go again. You have got to be much more deliberate. I might as well be sitting on him because you're not telling him any more than I am from here. Get him solid. Get him pushed up there with your leg. Get your knees straight. No, get your knees. Sit, Tanner. Good. Now sit down close. Hold your reins and push. Then stay back. That's straight. Smoothly back. Smoothly back. Smoothly back. So you can't keep riding these horses with one rein. You're going to ride with your seat and your leg and two reins. Even as you pull up there, you pull up with one rein. So he's popping his shoulder, he's changed his lead half a dozen times. You better ride that horse forward and straight, or the jump is never going to happen. Go one more time. Forward and straight to the jump, forward and straight to the stop. You better have a tight leg. That counts. Get your lead. Slow down, get your lead. What leg are you using? I'm not seeing, I'm seeing a lot of inside. Sit down, hands down, and push your horse. To two hands, two reins, steering. Straight, straight, smoothly, straight, left leg. And turn right. Left leg, don't pull. Push, 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 push. Hey, nothing. When I say push, I expect to see a horse move. Push! Push! I can't help you if you don't respond. When I say push, I want to see the horse change. I don't want to see it stay like this, then I feel like I'm talking to myself. Okay, okay. Steer with your leg. Push! Push! And then steer. You do not get to use your reins until you push that horse forward. That's a luxury we only get to use the reins once we move them forward. Good. Forward and to the right. Left leg turns horse again. So we're always teaching them the horses to move away from our legs. Behind this horse and make sure that it doesn't back out on you. But you won't have to override, but it is still coming. Squeeze tight. Squeeze it. Squeeze it. Turn around. Kick it hard. You can't let it back out of the bridle. Wait, could you feel the last couple strides that horse kind of locked its ears? And you've got to be right. Don't wait. See whether it's a good distance or bad distance. Doesn't matter. Don't tell that horse, don't you back out of here. So go. Okay? Okay. Can't do that. Now I want you to use your ankles like a massage on that horse's side. Lean back and massage it, massage it, massage it, massage it, massage it. Pluck it. Okay. Now actually the horse did a pretty good job there because you were pulling just as much as you were pushing. Go one more time. You've got to keep the horse taking a little hold of you. Don't start, just because it won't take hold of you, don't you start taking hold of it in front of the jump. Pluck it up and make it take hold of you. Just canter and circle half the ring and jump it. You don't have to go to the end. So with this horse, you have to stay well back to guard the back door that it won't slip out. Lean back, sit down, close. And I want every stride, your ankles. Push. 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 There you go. Good. That's what I want. Good. So when you have one you're not sure you can trust, you really have to ride a little bit in the back seat, and you have to massage it with your leg every stride. Don't just try to ride to the distance that you think is going to work and then add leg, because that horse, when it feels it, it just shuts right down on you. You've got to have it already coming up. Okay, we're gonna have Melissa go one more time. Lively, with heart. Come on, with spirit. You gotta want to now. Ankle, use that ankle. So you see a lot of people use their leg. They can't use your knee, can't use your leg like a club. You have to push your ankle into the horse and grind your foot up and down so they feel that. It makes a much stronger leg. Just squeezing with it sometimes is not good enough. You have to squeeze with it and then grind it. Now, what leg are you using?
My outside.
Well, that horse is not moving off of the outside. I don't want you to use the inside at all. Now, with spirit now, let's have a little liveliness. Make that horse pull you. See if you can make it run away with your hands down. That's it. Two reins. Right rein, right rein, right rein, right rein, right rein. One more time. No. Do not steer with a waving hand. We're steering with our leg. If you learn nothing today, it's going to be learning about your leg is what makes that horse go forward. Then you can gently guide it. But it has to move off your leg. Now be careful when you canter, because it's going to pick up the wrong lead. Shorten your rein a little bit. Sit. Right leg. Good. Turn so you don't go too far away. Hands low. Sit down in the saddle. Don't stand up. Sit down. That's fast enough. Now straight. Straight. Right rein. Right rein. Right rein. Right rein. Good. Turn right. Forward. And turn right. Both leg. Good. That was a big improvement. You have to discipline yourself to make sure you use your leg before you touch those reins, okay? That was much better. Much better. And when you landed, right away, the horse started to drift and you started straightening it with the right rein. That was good. Then didn't get away from it. Okay, we've all done this. Leg just behind, not so far behind the girth, close to the girth. Much better. Make a strong leg. Hand low. Every stride, leg, 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 leg. That's what I want. That was good. Straight. Good. Forward and turn to the right. Forward and then turn right. Good. Much better. So that horse will actually jump. He really wants to hold anyway. So you can ride at him pretty firmly, even if he's going to be a little deep. You know, your instinct is, in a way, it's not a bad instinct. You realize you're going to be a little deep sometimes, so you want to kind of take back to help him so he's not so deep. But in doing so, he slows his motion down and stiffens his back. He holds himself off enough to keep the leg on him a little bit. So you want to keep your foot to the inside of the stirrup so the branch, so I can stick my finger in the back. Okay? That keeps us calf tighter. The leg is right here. And you can almost ride when you run on the side. I'd ride a very long way. So your leg gets too far back. Your leg gets too far back, you tend to get too far back. Okay, now we're going to jump right knee canter and come around, come up over the little gate to that little brown hoop. It's on a broken line. So when you jump a broken line, how should you jump the first fence? Should you jump perpendicular to it? Should you angle it? What's the best way to approach that? Everybody? Angle it across. You want to angle the first one. So when you come out of that corner over there, you're looking, and you don't turn early. You turn a little late so that you jump the first fence. Here's the first fence here. I jump it on a little bit of a slice to the right. So I'm already aimed straight toward the second jump. And the reason I do that is why? Why don't I just go straight and then turn? You might have a lead change problem there. This way, pick a straight line, doesn't matter what lead you're on. That was good, very nice. Now, I don't know if you could all see when she came across the center there, that horse wanted to bulge a little bit right. If you're watching closely, she just took that right rein and her right leg against that horse's side to block it so they don't bulge their shoulders or bulge their hind end. Okay. Who do we have next? We'll have Ivy go. Ivy, want to go next? Don't pull, push. Steer by pushing and then guiding. Wide turn so you can line those two up on a straight line. Hand down. Nope, stop. Now, could you all see when she came around that turn what she did? Do you know what she did as you made that right hand turn? Keep that hand down. Start again. Every time you do that, you shorten your stride up and stiffen their back. Make sure you swing wide. Don't turn too soon. Stay over in the corner. Lean back. Hands down now. Don't you pick them up. Ride with your leg, not your hand. Leg. You pull. Stop. I want you to ride with your leg. Don't keep kicking back in front of the jump. It doesn't matter if the distance is perfect or not. Don't kick back the last three strides. Wide turn. Find yourself a line. Hand low. Very low and ride forward. Yes. Ride forward and then decide what you want to do. Yeah, okay, good. So when you have horses that don't go forward, that don't advance, don't try and take you, you cannot kick back at them. You have to override them forward well before you see any distance. Don't worry about it. You better get them going forward and look for a distance after you get them going forward. Okay, go. You're going to stay well behind your horse. You're going to keep your leg on it every stride. And you're going to give it a little cluck about 2 to 3 strides away from the jump. Doesn't mean you have to go faster. You're just going to cluck and keep your hand very low. Cluck. That's right. Stay down. Hand down. Cluck. Ah, get up. Kick it on. Okay, turn it right around. Jump that jump. Wide turn. Wide. Leg. Where's your left leg? Light, tight leg. Tight leg. Let's come around and do those two jumps again. Try the same too. So you've got to override this horse a little bit. You can't just ride into the nice, comfy spot. Even if it means overriding the distance, you make sure he stays out in front of you. Hand down, sit. Leg now. Every stride. Slow. Every stride. Let me see your leg. Hand down as you use your leg. Good. Okay. Okay, where are we going here? Jamie, who's going here? Austin, ready? Think about what you have to do, and that's a lively pony. Don't be nice to that pony. Patient, but not nice. Sit and canter. Hand down. Put those hands down. That right hand down on your neck. Down. Push. Aggressive. Come on. I can meet it today. Come on. No. Circle. So you didn't give the... Wait. You didn't give the pony a chance, did you? Here. Wait. Go straight over there. Look at me. Go straight over there, pick up your canter and go. Make sure you get your canner going somewhere before you head for any jumps. Canner? And get a strong canner. Strong. Wide turn. Stay out now, Austin. Stay out. Now turn. Hands down. And push that pony for all your worth with your leg. Push it! As hard as you can. Push it. That's it. Good. Hands down. Both hands down. Down. Leg on. Leg on. Hard. Hard. Good job. All right. Nice. And walk. All right. Good. So the first refusal was your fault. And you have to be careful that you don't make too many mistakes and make it your fault. Because every time they do something like that, they think, oh, maybe that's okay. You want to make sure that you don't leave the door open that they can interpret it the wrong way. Same. Take your time to get the canner, right? Get the canner, get the rhythm, then head to the jump. Good. Wide turn, too. You're not going to turn early, James. Stay on the railing until you see a nice straight line across you. Circle. So you're going to stay over further. Yeah. Bigger turn. You're a bigger turn. Not smaller. Bigger. Bigger. Canter. A little stronger. That's it. Now line the first jump up with the second one. First one up with the second one. No. 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 Circle. Circle. So you've got to be able to draw a straight line. If we tied a string from that end of the ring to that end of the ring, to the middle of those two jumps, that's where you're supposed to be going. Absolutely straight from that fence. You're going to jump that one at an angle, so you're already straight to the second one. You're too much of an angle. Too much of an angle. Come around again. Hand down. Softly now. Take your time getting into the canter. Make sure you get the lead you want. Sit and canter. Good. Stay on the rail. Stay out. Stay out. Stay out. Come on, keep cantering. Now turn. Now look at the second jump. Keep your eye on the second jump. Go on. Up, circle, circle. We're going to go back to this one again. Two rein. Don't pull, don't pull. Wide. Don't keep stopping when you have trouble. Smoothly go forward. Remember, you're always going to go forward. So always go smoothly forward to slow down to start again. Let's try again. Canter. So cluck, but look now. Look at the first one, line it up for the second, put your hands down. Down. Good. Keep your hands down. Push, push, push. Every stride, push, 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 push. That's straight. That's it, straight. Good. Let's come on back, Jamie, and do those two one more time. That was better, but you've got to have a little more rhythm going forward so you can steer. If you let the rhythm get too weak and then you go to steer, it slows them down more and you lose the distance to the jump. You want to sit and then canter. Good. Stay on the railing. Push your horse over with your right leg a little bit to keep it from cutting faster, faster, faster. Look at the jump. Good. Ride right to it. Push, push, everything, push. Don't pull, push, don't pull. Good. Now push. Don't pull. Push. 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 Yes. Very good. That's what we're after. That was very good. Okay. Push straight to stop. Good. Okay. Now with spirit now. You've been standing around. So make sure that one's alert and awake, right? Awake. You want to make it extra lively. I want it extra lively. Push. More, more, more. I want to see how fast you can go. How fast can there? I want you to see how fast you can make this horse go with your hand low. Fast! Fast! Good. Fast with your hand down. Fast with your hand. That's right. Now we're cooking. Yes. Very good. Very good. Straight, 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 straight. And so you want to be aware when you land what lead your horse is on, so that you can stop it on that lead. Did your horse stay on the lead that it landed on? No. So we have to be careful when we land to keep riding straight. And if it's on the right lead, we have to ride it to an open right rein. If it's on the left lead, ride it to an open left rein so it doesn't change lead. That was much better. You can see where you have to ride this horse forward, right? Then he really gets in gear. Every horse is different. Some take just a little squeeze. someone dragging you out of the tack, that one needs a push, a real good push. And he's a smart enough and a good enough jumper that he can handle it. So I want you to watch Elizabeth go so she can show us the angle that I'm talking about coming out of the turn. Gets a nice, easy rhythm, but solid. Looks, lines up for two jumps. And straight, straight, straight. Stops on the right lead. Turns right. Forward to turn right. Good. Good. A little uneven because she had a little bit of a quiet first one and then a little bit of a forward second one. Row is looking, the ideal thing, you pick up a rhythm, it doesn't change, and the fences become just another step in your course. So it's not a big change at that. Is everybody done this? Okay. Now we're gonna go ahead and pick up a left lead canter and canter down over that white gate to those white rails. Now the distance is 71 feet. You wanna have some numbers in your mind what 71 feet means. How many strides does 171 feet mean to you? Five. Is that a normal five?
It's a long five.
A little what? A little short? What is it short of? Pardon?
Short 12 inches.
You're right. 1 foot short. Because you want to think about 12 foot on the distance is 12 foot. Each stride is 12 feet. So when you have 71 feet, normal 12-foot stride would be 72 feet, and that would be 5 strides. Now this other side, but 71, is 1 foot short, but we haven't jumped it today. It's near the speakers, it's near the people sitting there, which could distract your horse and hold your horse back. We are jumping toward the in gate, that's a little bit of a help, but it's still the first time it's going to ride forward, a little forward for you one way or the other, whether you want to ride 4-5 strides or even 6, it still won't be strangling. When we go to do the other side over there, that's 83 feet from the lattice to the wall, which we're not doing right this second. But 83 feet, how many strides do you think that is? 6. How many strides is a normal 6 strides? If you were working on a 12-foot basis. Pardon? 84, right. So this is 83, 1 foot short. Again, it's coming toward your home, so that's good. But the wall, which is a little more substantial, so that might hold them a little bit. But the first time down on the line, they'll hold a little bit. Second time, they'll start moving forward. You have to decide who you're riding and how many strides you want to make it be. You have a strong, long-strided horse, brave, heck, then you probably should go ahead and do the 5. Do you have a horse that's a little timid or a little anxious, a little nervous, then you might first time do the 6. You have to know with the horse that you're riding what strides you're working for. You have to know as you land over the first fence, as you land, you have about 3 seconds to decide whether you're going to continue forward and do the 5 or steady back and do the 6. The deal is you have to make that adjustment before the center of the ring. So when you're going from that one fence to that, you mean the center between those two jumps, so that you're not messing with the horse in front of the second jump. You want to make your adjustment as you land. There's another adjustment, that's the circle. I didn't like it, I think I'm gonna try it again. That's a do-over. Having jumped it that way, she would have had no choice but to add. Otherwise, she would have to shoot that horse down there like a slingshot, which she doesn't want to do. That wasn't a great decision. She jumped in okay that time, but a little delayed moving up to do the 5. So the 5 became long, strong, and flat. You don't want to have to make the second fence long, strong, and flat. At that point, you're better just to be conservative and go again. Let's go one more time, and let's go ahead and do the 6. So just keep a little calmer. Remember, whatever you do in front of a fence, you will pay for on the random side. You shoot that horse forward and lead long, he is going to be long and flat and strong on the landing. It'll take 2 men and a strong boy to get him back for the turn. You want that fence just to happen to be the right spot for you just to step over. Lean back a little bit, settle your pace, Not too much impulsion for this little jump. Hand very low. Voice, voice, voice. That's better. Hand low, hand low, hand low, hand low. If you pick your hand up again, the horse's back will stiffen and you'll swap leads behind and they'll throw their head in the air. You have to keep your hand low. Okay. Who's ready there? A pony rider. Austin. You ready? And you gotta crank that pony up, Austin. Don't let it go to sleep on you. Gonna keep those hands down. Sit. Ask it to canter. Sit, canter. Now ask it to canter faster with your hands very low. That's good. Hands very low. Leg very tight. Hand low and leg tight. Leg tight. Up, leg tight. That'll go. Left leg. Hand low, leg tight. Up. Kick him up here. Kick hard. Kick your pony hard. Kick. Good. Turn right around. Wide turn. Take your time now. You're okay. Wide turn. Slow. Two rein. Hands low. Hands low. Sit close to your tack and keep your leg tight. Good. Straight. Straight. That's it. Straight. Let's go around and do that line once more. Awesome. One more time. Gotta keep the reins short, but hands low. And you've got to sit up and keep your leg tight in front of the jump. Sit down in your tack right now. Sit. Hands very low. Sit down. Hands low and leg tight. Tight, tight. Okay, make a circle. Now, you know what happened? You know, wait. You know what happened there? Raising its tail.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we'd like it to continue anyway. Go again. Hands low. That's it. Now, think about those hands very low. Your seat close to the saddle with your leg squeezing. Left leg. Good. Whoop. Circle, circle, circle. Take your time, get your stirrup back. Take your time, don't hurry, don't hurry. Okay. Yeah, don't hit it. Right rein. Now, on the way to that jump, I saw an awful active left rein again. We can't be active with that left rein, or we're going to pull the pony to a halt. Hands low. Okay, canter. Good. Hand down, left hand down by your knee. Leave it there. Now reach up. Up. Good. Straight. Right rein. Right rein. Right rein. Right rein. Right rein and stop. Right rein. Stop. 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 Don't let the pony drag you around there. You're supposed to stop on a straight line. Okay. So a little bit the time before was your fault because as you came around that corner, you started to pick with that left hand again. And that pony would love to have an excuse not to continue. So you gotta make sure you don't give it an excuse. You keep that hand low. Okay, where are we on the list here? Jamie? There. Pluck. That's good. Straight and stop. Straight. Right rein. And then forward and forward and turn right. Forward. That's right. Good, Jamie. Good. Very good. Okay. Lean back a little bit. Don't get ahead with your shoulders. And don't ride with your hand, ride with your leg, making the pony reach for your hand. Reach, make it reach, make it reach. Circle. You see how tight that jump was? If you make it reach earlier, it would have left that stride out. You might have to use a little cluck when you want it to come forward with your leg. But just because your pony won't go forward, you can't pick up the slack with your hand. You've got to ride aggressively forward from your leg Now, think about gallop. Gallop. Good. Yes. Lean back, lean back. That's it. Don't get ahead of your pony. And then walk forward, turn right. Left leg, don't pull it, push it around the turn. Good. So if you get behind it, it won't take any hold anyway, so really push it a lot to try and make it take a little bit of hold. But I know the feeling when you're trying to get a horse to go forward and they're not going forward and there's a slack in the rein, you know you don't like that idea, so you take hold. I don't want you to take, you're going to have to push harder and make them take hold to pull the slack out of your hand. Keep your weight well back and close to the tack, like you're sitting with no stirrups. And see, leg tight while you wait for the jump. Tight. Good. Wait. Tight. Nice. Good. Nice. Good. Walk forward and turn right. Much better. I want you to think about galloping. You're in a gallop. Come on, that's not even a canter. Gallop. Show me gallop. Gallop. Come on. Hard. Gallop. Go. Go. Gallop. Keep galloping. Good. Even though that fence was tight, that's what I'm after. And that was much straighter. Forward, turn right. Left leg, not hand, left leg, that's your right leg. Which is your, show me your right leg. Okay, now use your left leg. I want to make sure that other one isn't working. Okay, that was much better, much straighter, even though you had a close fence at that, it's fine. Make the mistake because you rode forward. Don't make the mistake because you never rode at all, okay? Good. Are we all gone? Okay, let's put Elizabeth, I always forget to cut her out. And walk forward and turn right. Now, this is the first time I really noticed this horse look like it was pretty strong. Was it pretty strong there?
Yeah.
Does it do that very often?
I've only ridden here for a couple of times, but it seems to take over at the end.
Yeah, let's do just that line again, see if you can soften it up a little bit. So no matter what distance we're thinking about, see if you can kind of soften her up when she lands on it after that first one. Use a little voice and then hand. See if you can get her to lighten up so she doesn't keep pulling her head down each stride. Hit her head up a little. Half halt. That's right. Half halt. Yes, that's what you need. Half halt up there. Yeah, you feel the difference there? Yeah, when she gets her head buried down and starts pulling you down, it just becomes a tug of war. So you have to, that was very good riding. You know, you kind of give her a little half halt off the top. Then she kind of lightened up in front. Then when you actually went to pull up, it wasn't that hard to pull up. That was good. Okay, now is everybody okay? Now we're going to work on the right knee canter and down the far side over the lattice to the wall. So I'm going to have the rest of you line up over there by the white gate so people can see across the ring. Okay. Relax your arm. Don't ever let your arm get stiff now. Make that. Because that just transmits right to your horse. You've got to keep it relaxed. try and settle down on the tack if that horse will let you, and take a little bit every stride with your arm relaxed. Little at a time. Good. Very good. Good. And walk forward and turn left. Good. Relax a little bit. You had a lead change, right? To trying to get pulled up on a straight line. And not bad. Jumps were pretty darn good. Lean back a little bit. Let the horse come forward. You're going to push it or push harder. No pulling. You can either push or push harder. Push or push harder. Right leg, push or push harder. Right leg, at you pull. You can't pull. You have to steer that pony with your leg and not so much picking, picking, picking with your hand. You've got to push it over with your leg. Go back and do those two again. Go ahead and trot across the ring and pick up your can and go. Lean back, lean back. So the choices on this pony are push or push harder. Won't be any pulling, whether it's in right or wrong. And if you're pushing and you think you want the long jump and you think it should be done that way, add a cluck the last couple strides. Lean back, no rein, think about no hands. Push or push more. Cluck. And cluck. Let go. Let go. There you go. Good. Good. All right. Much better. And walk and turn left. Okay. Jamie, slow. Slow yourself down. Think what you want to do. Walk forward. Then trot a couple steps. Canter. Two reins. Good. Nice. Now build a little bit of RPM, a little bit more impulsion. Every stride with your right leg. Keep the horse over there, every stride. A little cluck. Yes, hand down, hand down. Okay, straight, 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 straight. Forward, forward, and turn left. Forward, and turn left, and turn left. Forward, and turn left, good. Let's go back to it once more. That's fine, first fence is very good. Second fence got to be an optional distance there. Take your time, trot across there smoothly, get the correct lead, and then we'll think about the jump. Okay, try and keep those hands low, two of them low and straight. Good. The rein should be short but not tight. Push a little with your right leg to keep your horse from cutting. That's it, little right leg. Good. Right leg. Right leg. Good. Straight, 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 straight. Walk forward and turn left. Right leg, right leg, right leg. No rein, right leg. Good. Good. Get used to using your leg. That was good. Okay, come on. You know you have to stay back and deep in the saddle. You've got to override this distance. Got to keep pushing the horse up in the last three strides, cluck, whether it's short, long, or indifferent. Okay, keep cantering, go around again. Now we're going to canter around, do it again. I know you can't quite trust this horse, but try not to any more than you have to with your rein. We'll do those two jumps again. So right when you think you want to pick, I want you to cluck and see if that horse won't come up and take a little bridle and continue. Seat close, lower leg every stride, nudging it just a little bit. Sit down. Cluck. Yeah. Sit down. Stay seated. Stay seated. Good. Good. Okay. Forward and to the left. Forward first. Forward and then left. Turn with your right leg. Good. Much better. Much better. Okay, make sure that pony's alive and awake. And those hands stay down. And we steer with our legs. Get your canter going. So you have it established. Make a circle. Make a circle. Because we want to get that canter going before we head for any jumps. Big circle. Pass the hand down. Right rein. Use the right one. Left leg. Good. Good. Stronger canter. Stronger. Stronger. Little gallop now, Austin. Mean it with your legs. Mean it. Buck. Good. Straight. Push, 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 don't go push. That's it, good, good. All right, and walk. Good, much better. Have we all done this yet? No. Now lively with feeling, a little gallop. You have to use that stick or something, wake them up, wake them up. Make them gallop. This gallop, that's not even a fast canter. Gallop, don't jump if you can't gallop. Show me gallop. Nope, circle. That's not enough of a gallop. Circle. Gallop. Come on, legs. Legs, hard. Fuck. Get it going. Left leg, steer with your legs. That's better. Keep going, fast. I want you to gallop this line. That's right, legs. Think about galloping. Galloping. Good. Galloping. Galloping. Yes, good. And back. Gently, and a gently walk forward and turn left. Forward. Good, much better. So really, when you get used to this horse, I think you'll find that it's very little that you have to do other than gallop. If you can get the gallop going, he kind of gets in your spirit and really takes over his foot. But when you let him slumber, it goes nowhere. Again, that's right, you want to let that horse bear down on you. Give it a little half halt and soften, half halt and soften, half halt and soften. That's right. Good. A little half halt and soften, half halt, that's good. 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 Left rein. Good. Walk forward, turn left. Let's go back and do it once more and see if you can soften it up one more time.
Or go once more.
Pardon? Yeah. And, you know, maybe they'll let you and maybe they won't.
Yeah.
And when you go to take back, are you using your voice before you take back? Yeah, good. Try and get it where it's not bearing down on you on the way to the jump. Sort of let it go into the canter, don't make it. So you've got to try and make a relaxed horse out of it, out of this turn, as though there's no jump there. You're just trying to relax the canter. Easy, right rein, right rein. Good. Right rein, off the neck, right rein, right rein. Good. Very good. And walk forward and turn left. Good. Much better. Much better. Okay, where are we here? Are we all gone? Okay, good. Okay, so now we're going to try and put one little course together. It's going to be a right lead canter up over the brown gate to the brown coop. Turn left, down over the far side, the white to the white. Around, up over this white gate, which we haven't jumped yet, to the white gate with the pink flowers. This is also a broken line, so you treat this broken line just like we treated that broken line. We go wide and we jump this fence. We turn, well this one we turn a little bit early on so that we line up that end of the ring with the center of this jump so we can ride straight to that white jump so we don't have a big kink in the middle of it. And then down the far side and finish with a finishing circle. The rest of you could stand like at the trot jump because they're going to use this end to do a finishing circle. Maybe a little bit over here with a group. Easy. Off. Taking like that, taking like that. Okay. Hands low and steady. Don't let your arm get stiff and don't let it bounce. Low hand, no bouncing, no bouncing. And you probably use your voice with your hand if the horse gets a little strong and locked. Hands down, hands down. Don't let your hands start flying up and down because that's, when you do that, the stride keeps getting longer. Let's start again. Let's start from the beginning. Don't look at me for a minute, Anna. Make sure that your hands, you let those arms start to stiffen. They start to do this. And then instead of getting quieter, the horse gets more excited and then you just leaves it out. Try and keep your hand as low as you can, as steady as you can. Remember, when you do a course, break it up in your mind into a line and then a turn, and then a line and then a turn. Don't let yourself get overwhelmed with the course. Two fences at a time. Slower, slower, softer. Circle, circle, hand down, hand down. So no matter how strong that gets, that horse gets, don't get tempted in fixing your hand up. It keeps on stiffening its back and then it wants to change its weight. Soft in the canter. Let it go into the canter. And then balance it. Now feel the stride every time, every stride, treat your hands a little bit. Hand low. Just take a little, take a little, take a little, soften and allow. Now take a little, take a little, take a little. Hand down into it. Soften and allow. Slow down, let it catch up, slow down, and catch up. Good. Hand low, take a little, soften. Take a little, take more. That's right. Okay. Hand down, hand down, hand down. Hand down. Hand very low. Stay back a little bit. Hand low. Good. Come around again. Why don't we do this whole line? I mean, I don't think it's afraid of the jump. I mean, I don't know how green this horse is. This horse pretty green? Pretty green. Okay. Come around and jump this one. You jump this one good. Held a little bit and jumped nicely. Then balance it back. But you can see your tracks, how far off to the left you are on that second.
Left, yeah.
Yeah. So if it's that green, you just can't afford to let it get to the one side or the other. Again, very low hand. Canter as though there's no jump. Stay back. And let go. Stay back. Right rein, right rein. Good. That was a good option. You know, there's no point in continuing on if they're cross-cantering or running off. You gotta get them back in balance. And low and steady. No matter how much difficulty they give you, don't let your hands bounce. That's better. And low. No matter how strong they get, don't stiffen your arms. Keep taking and taking a little more. Take a little more and then back to your trot. Okay, good. So no matter how strong they get, you can't panic. You're gonna have to hold them the best you can, but don't all of a sudden suddenly take a strong hold or throw their head up and stiffen their back, because then not only do they not come back very well, but they're in a terrible position to try and use their parts to jump. And if this were, how much jumping has this horse done?
He does little courses like this and the baby green stuff.
Right, and does he get strong or not strong?
He doesn't like the turn right.
He doesn't like the turn right.
So
Now we're going to stay back, we're going to keep our hands low, and the choices are push or push harder, but don't start nicking at with your hands. Lay your hand low. Make a circle again. Circle. So and get that lead. Stay with the lead. And low. Don't let your hands come up. Bury them. That's better. Bury them. Push. And push harder. Hard. You pull them into a hole again. Stop. You can't keep taking back the last step and making put in another step. Then pretty soon he thinks that's the way you always want to do it. Hand low. When you pick up your hand, the stride shortens. We want a longer stride out of this horse, this pony. We want to make a long stride out of this pony. Low hand. Low and push. Low. That's not low. There, that's low. Keep them down there. Keep them down by your knees. Yes. That's good. As you come out of the corner, those hands down by your knees as you get close to the jump. Push them down and push with your leg. Push them down and push with your leg. Yes, that's good. Great. That's good. Settle the pony down. Settle down. Settle down. Hands low and stay back. It's a new jump. Stay back. Pluck. That's it. Straight to the center. Good. Good. Slow. Hands down. Hands down. Stay there. Keep them buried. Keep them buried while you ride. Yes, that's what I wanted. That was great. I don't know if you could see with that horse, that last line there, kept your hands down, the horse automatically came forward, lengthened, and gave her the long jump. Forward, 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 get the lead. Lean back, and gently ride forward to slow down. Don't let it back out of the bridle. Make it go forward. That a girl. And now back. And you don't want to stop by the gate. You always like to stop away from the gate. But you do want to ride it forward to slow it down. That was good. That was pretty darn well ridden. Very good. Okay, look. And again, break it up into lines and turns. Don't let the courses overwhelm you. Think about the turns are just as important as the jumps. If you don't have a good turn, you're probably not going to have a good jump. The corners are where you go ahead and do your homework to get your horse prepared for the line. So it's a soft, relaxed gait. So you're not balancing on your hand. That's right. Good. Take it back gently, like you're going to walk maybe. Yeah. Right. Now she has to relax it around this turn as though there's no jump again. So it stops leaning against the bridle and just canters. Just canters. That's right. Nice. Just canters. Just canters. Okay. Let's go back and do that line again. You're doing pretty good. You're doing pretty good. And the first time she's okay, then locked in again. And unfortunately, when they lock in against you like that, you can't let them do that. And you can't let them just lock in and drag you down over the jump. Even if it's a good distance and it ends up a good jump, you can't allow them to take over. They have to come back. They have to balance back when you ask them to balance back. If they don't, you balance them back hard so that they add the stride and don't drag. Right rein, right rein, right rein. Good. Good. Right rein. Good. Okay, not bad. Much better. And you can see when she pulled up here to do a simple change, up there she did the flying change, did it correctly, right? Why did she pull up to do a simple change here? Quieter. Those changes. I mean, especially if you have, even if they do them well, changes tend to get their adrenaline going. But if they don't do them particularly well and you have to force an issue, it really gets the adrenaline going. She was already trying to put out the fire without asking it to worry about the change along with it. So you have to decide sometimes what's more important. What am I working on today? Am I working on getting this horse slow and quiet and controlled for the jumps? Or am I working on changes today? Slow and quiet and controlled for the jumps. I'll work on changes after that. Really with a lot of spirit here. Remember, we learned galloping is good on this horse. Galloping. That's not a gallop. Galloping is good. Because you don't get to steer if you don't gallop. Galloping. Galloping. Keep galloping. Keep galloping and then you can steer a little bit. That's right. You cluck. There you go. Good. Keep that rhythm. Keep galloping. Don't go resting. The turns are as important as the jumps. Hands down and gallop. Let's get the gallop. Don't wait. Good. Hands down. Yes. Great. Change. Get the other half. Slow down. Let him finish it up. Slow down. Let him catch it up. Keep cantering now. Come out of your corner. Good. Gallop. 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 Yep. Come right around. Come right around. Get going. You've got to be more aggressive than that. We hadn't jumped that jump before. You came around like you should know. He thought you were going to run him into the standard. Look, point to the center and push him. Left leg, hard. That's right. Good. Left leg steers him. Now both legs. Left leg, hard. Good. Keep your gallop. Come on, gallop. No resting. No resting. Come on, you're losing rhythm. You're losing it. Come on, gallop. You're too slow. Gallop. Gallop. Look. There's what we want. We can get them going forward. Keep your canter. Canter. Pass the kin gate. Come on around here. Finish your circle. Canter. 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 Left leg. Hard. Left leg. Left leg. Left leg. Make him move over there. Okay, and walk. Okay, you've got to keep that gallop going or you can't steer. The minute you steer and have him going too slow, he just stopped. Turned away. Think about it with lines and turns. Don't get overwhelmed with the whole course. You've got to stay solid there for that horse. Lastly, stride, you're going to pluck whether it's short or long. Sit, pluck. But don't pull when you pluck. Slow, sit close. Keep your leg there. Lean back, new jump. You haven't jumped yet. Stay back. Be ready with your pluck. You don't want to rush it because you want to be solid. Pluck, pluck, pluck. You're slowing down. You see how he's pulling down now? Keep his head up. That's better. Okay. Okay, and walk. Head up. Push his head up. Head up. So when you go to stop him, just on the flat even, don't let him roll up and pull you down like that. Even it takes you a little longer to stop him, use a little half halt to make him canter slower and slower with his head up a little bit as he stops. Because I know the feeling going around him, just rolling along down the hill. If you pull too hard, you're afraid you're going to stop. That's right. Okay. Has everybody gone now? No. Jamie. Okay. Big wide turn, forward, then canter, then we think about the fences. Left rein, not so much right rein against his neck. Canter a little faster. Good, Jamie. Keep cantering. You want to keep going. Stop, stop, snap. Did you think you were straight to that fence? Stop, stop, no. Were you straight to that jump? When you want to be on an angle, wait, you want to be on an angle straight to the next one. But when you come out of that corner, you want to be straight. Let me show you. Look at your tracks. You want to go wide so you can get a straight line from this jump to the other jump. So you want to come from here, which is good. But you see those marks there? See those tracks? See how they went way left and then back right? You want to stay out here and then you want to jump from here. Watch. I don't want that part. I don't want that part. Then you went too far left to go too far right. And that is surprising. He was a good sport about it. Let's try again. Stay close to the rail. Canter. Stay out. And look, line those two up. Pick a straight line. A straight. Straight, straight, straight. Circle, we're going to try that once more. Push. So still there was a little zigzag coming in there. He has to go straight, jumping that fence on an angle, but go straight to the jump from the turn. Stay on the turn. Stay out. Now, make a straight line. Jump forward. That's better. Keep going. Keep going. Push, push so you can steer. Stop. So we have to push. We have to push enough, Jamie, that you can steer him. He's kind of so slumbery there that every time you go to steer him, he zigzags and starts to rip break. So we got to push him a little bit more, okay?
Do you want your stick?
Sit and canter. Get your rhythm now. Don't wait. Leg tight. Leg tight. Tighten your leg. That's it. Tighten your leg now. Tighten it. Hard. Come on. And tighten it again, and then you steer. Tighten it, and then you steer. Yes. Yes. Good. Good. Get a little more. Get your lead. Get your lead. Straighten out. Make a circle if you need to. Make a circle so he can correct his lead. Okay, now push him on a little bit stronger. Remember, we have to push him so that we can steer it. Leg, push, both legs. Push him. Good, push him, and then just steer a little bit. Push him. Push him. Nice, push him. Push him. And then steer. Yes, that's right. That's right. Keep steering, use the end of the ring. Stay on the wall. Leg, into your leg, John. Leg, pluck, pluck, pluck. Look around for this next jump. Push, 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 pluck. Left, right ring, pluck. That's it. Look at the next fence and ride to it. Go to it. Push to it. Don't pull. Push to it. Push. Hard. Up. Turn right around. All right. Come back again. Come back over here. I want you to do the whole line. It's not the jump. It's just when you get busy steering, it gets him a little confused where the next jump is going to be. Try this one again to that one. Okay? And low. Tanner early. Tanner. Hold him out. Don't cut the corner. Look. That's right, Jamie. Good. Now, look. Draw a straight line to the white gate. Ride forward to it. Good. Ride forward to it. Hard leg. Legs to go to the center. Push. Pluck. All right. Good. Continue. Push. Push. Stronger. Got to get stronger. Faster. Faster, Jamie. There. Keep it going. Good. Keep it going. Faster. Yes, that's what we want. Good. Keep cantering. Push. 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 So you go past the gate and around the corner. Push. Push. Okay, and walk. Okay, good. So you really got to, when you come out of your corner, you've got to line up, you have one straight line. You can't veer back out and then back in again. That gets him a little off balance. He's not ready to jump yet. He's good. Where are we on this? Pardon?
Austin.
Okay, Austin. So, Austin, you make a big circle first so you get cranked up and get that pony's rhythm going before you aim for any jumps. Make a circle on this end of the ring, then go. So go ahead and trot. Big circle. Bigger. Livelier. Livelier. Get the canter early now. Get the canter early. Go on. You got to get cantering now. Shorter rein, hands low. Stronger. Your hands are too busy up in the air. Push them down. Push. You can't be wishy-washy. Legs. Legs. Push. 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 Don't steer with your arms. Steer with your legs. Great. Push. But you can see what he did, Jamie, that little weave. That's what you did. That little weave coming to the first one. Keep pushing. Come on. Use your legs. Hand low and see how fast you can make the pony go. Hand down, right rein, right rein. Let go of the left, let go of the left. That's right, that's right. Straight, that's right. Stay out on the railing now. Keep your canter going and look around the turn. Look, start your turn. Keep cantering when you turn. Keep cantering. Push, hand down, left hand down. That's right, good. And left hand down, right rein. Push, left leg, push. Kick that pony up. Kick it hard. Make it an unpleasant experience. Kick it hard. Hand, right hand down. Don't be picking that right hand up in front of your face. Left leg. And now left, go on left rein as well. Push. Or keep your canter. Hands low. And steer with your legs. Right leg. Hard. Good. Right leg. Hard. Nice. And straight. Okay, good. And make a circle. Sit down and push around the circle. Push. Hands down. Hands down. Oops. Okay, straight. Okay. Now, hands down. Good. You're doing much better today about your hand. Much better about your hand. If we have time, we'll go up that line one further. Let's see if that's where we are on our list here. Back to the beginning. Then I want you to do this one line again. Okay, we're going to take a trot here. Canter here, turn around there, and jump just this gate. Let's do the four fences. Let's do this gate to that coop, and down that line. Just those four jumps. Lean back, slow down, think slowly. Straight, go to the cone, trotting, cone, cone. Go two rein, no zigzagging, no zigzagging. Ah! If you're gonna get rough, I'm not gonna have you do it. Hey, wait, listen to me. Look at me, look at me, look at me. If you're gonna get impatient, then don't do it at all because it's not fair to your pony. The pony will give you enough trouble even if you're doing it right. So let's make it smooth and right. Make it walk forward and trot smoothly. Two rein, don't wheel it around to the right. Go to the cone. No, no, stop. Where's the cone? Where, look at me for a minute. See that, look at me, look at me. Austin, Austin, look. See that cone, that orange cone? Walk to me, walk to me. Lean back, lean back. Okay. Turn to the right, go over to the railing and turn, go by that cone. See if make a wide turn, okay? Here with your legs now. Left leg turns your pony right. Right leg turns your pony left. Stay on the railing and trot. And then canter. Now sit and canter. Hand down. Don't put the right hand up. Push. We're going to do these four jumps. Push. Start your turn. Now turn. Turn. Now straight. Straight. And push. Hard. Flex the pony. Flex. Hand down, push, push that pony. Good, keep going. Keep your rhythm around the corner now. Don't slow down. Hands low, so you can help the pony. Hands low, soften the left rein. Left leg hard. Good, left leg hard. Let go of the left rein, let go of it. Yes, all right, that was great. And circle, that's a both rein, sit. Okay, and walk. Much better. You see, that pony got pretty good there at the end when you softened up that left rein and rode the pony forward. That was good. Okay.
That's it.
Are we out of time anyway?
Yeah, we're pretty
much out of time.
Yeah, then
we'll
probably get it.
Yeah, okay. 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 Did you want to look like you were ready to try it again or something? You all right? Okay.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.